Hello all, this will be a quick video on how to create a weighted column. So first thing you want to do is look for your grade center. Click on that, full grade center. You'll see up here, create calculated column and weighted column. That's what you want, weighted column. I'm going to name this weighted column because I'm very creative. I'd go ahead and leave this percentage. It's pretty much what everybody uses, but there are some other options. Score, letter, complete, incomplete. Just depends on how you want it to be viewable. Now you can select individual assignments to weight. So say you had assignment 1. Assignment 1 could be worth 5% of your grade. Assignment 2 could be worth 10% of your grade. Usually since there's multiple assignments, so you'll have, you know, maybe 5 assignments, 6 assignments, they're all going to be under the same category, assignment. Or you might have 5 discussion boards, and they're all going to be under the same category, under discussion. So we would recommend using the category section. So I have an example from a syllabus we use in one of our courses, and this is how they set up their weights. So assignments are worth 15%, quizzes are worth 10, exams 75%. So I'm going to go ahead and use this as a model. So first category should be assignments, 15%. You looked for that on here, assignment. There it is. Once you highlight that, click on this little arrow, it's pretty tiny, and it's worth 15%. And you'll see there's a running total down here. This needs to equal 100%. If not, your grades are gonna be all out of whack. By default, this is always gonna say equally. Now this is fine as long as, let's say you have 5 assignments and each assignment's worth 10 points each. I know that's not the case sometimes. You know, assignment 1 might be worth 5 points, assignment 2 might be worth 10 points. So if your assignments are all worth different amounts, click proportionally. So back to this example we have here, quizzes are worth 10%. Here's the quiz category, 10% proportionally. And the last one was exams that are worth 75%. And 75%. Proportional, and you can see it updated here to 100%. And scrolling on down, I'd recommend always clicking no on this. If you leave this at yes, if a student scores, like submits a paper or doesn't submit a paper, and you know the student gets 0 points for that, yes is not going to count that because there's no grade. So if you want to count, if the student gets 0 points on an assignment, you want to click no here. You always want to leave this as yes, because obviously it needs to calculate and go to your final grade column or your points column. This is all up to you if you want to show this to your students or not. Typically, we leave this as yes. And statistics, that's up to you. Typically, it's just left as no. So I'm going to go ahead and submit this. You'll see here, now we have this weighted column. And remember that the first drop-down box, you can select percentage, points, letter. That's going to change what it says right here. And one more thing I wanted to show you with the categories. So you see here, you have a category. These are all the assignments in this course. So in this category, all 3 of these assignments are listed as exams. This one's listed as a quiz. This one as a discussion. So you just want to make sure when you're adding categories in your weighted column that all your assignments are in the correct category. Now by default they should be, but it's good to check here just in case. And if you find, you know, they're not in the right category, they're really easy to change. So you just click these little boxes here. and then choose category. Now say I wanted to change this to a test instead. As you see, it changes it automatically to test. Very easy. All right, well, that is all I have. I hope this was helpful, and have a nice day.